Okay, so last time we had this kind of network, and what we wanted was to size a pump that will be able to pump water from this area here all the way to this area. And what we said is that we are going to size this pump by using two software. The first one was EPANET, and the other one was WaterGEMS software. But we covered WaterGEMS already, so in this tutorial, we are going to do the same work by using EPANET software. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so this is EPANET version 2.2, and this is what I am using currently. So if I go here, let me select project and select the defaults. And what I want is to make sure that at least I have settings that I need for my project. So from here, I don't think if I have anything I can change from here. Let me go straight to properties. And again, in properties, I don't think if I have anything that I can change. But what I want to make sure is that I am using the metric system, okay, the metric measurement system. And to achieve that, the only thing that I need to make sure that is to make sure that my flow or the discharge unit that I'm using for my project is in liters per second. And of course, for head loss formula, I'm going to use Hazen-Williams. So the rest, I don't think if I can change. So from here, I can just click OK. Okay, now that I have the settings that I need for my project, let me go back here and select import, then let me select network. Okay, so this is my network. Let me click open. For now, I have my network in EPANET format already, but if you want to learn how to import your data from Excel to EPANET format, I have two tutorials that I highly recommend you to go and watch, and I'll make sure that I include the link to both of them in the description below. So otherwise, let's proceed. Okay, so this is my complete network. As you can see, for now we have our links, but let me cross check if everything is in order. You can see we have the length here, and if I click any other link, you can see we have the links already. So from here, what I need to do next is, if I take you back here, you can see here we had a storage tank, but for now in our network we don't have a storage tank. But remember, our storage tank is located somewhere around this junction here. So what I need to do is to replace this node or junction with a storage tank. So from here, what I need to do is to delete this one and to replace it with the storage tank. So if I double click this, so let me make sure that I take this value here, which is 136.06. So from here, let me delete this one, because if I delete this, automatically I'm going to lose this pipe. So I make sure that I have its data written somewhere. So 136.06, then let me delete this and replace it with a storage tank. So let me take this and put it somewhere around this. And from here, let me take this link again and connect it with our tank. And from here, let me change it from 100 to 136.06. Okay, so the rest, I don't think if I can change for now. Then let me click close. But if I take you back here again, you can see around this point here we had a pump, but for now we don't have a pump in our network. Okay, we don't have a pump. So what can we do? Again, we need to add a pump around this point. But remember one thing: we are pumping water from a sump, and our sump has a depth of 2.5. So our pump is installed within that sump. So what we need to do from here is to make sure that we model our network in such a way that our pump is installed within that sump at a depth of 2.5 meters. So let me show you how we can do that. Okay, so remember this junction here has this value as the elevation. So apart from that, we also need to know that this junction here is located somewhere around this point, which is on the surface. But we need to minus 2.5 to get the actual elevation in which our pump is installed, of course, within the sump. So to achieve that, let me take this value here, which is 1138.2, and open this software here. 1138.2 minus 2.5. So this is the elevation at which our pump will be installed. So to achieve that, what I need to do is to introduce another junction somewhere here. Okay, so let me introduce another junction somewhere here. Okay, and give it elevation value of 1135.7, and also I need to connect this junction here with this one, okay? And this pipe here, okay, this pipe here need to have a length of 2.5, okay? 2.5. Okay, so what we need to do next is to introduce our pump. But remember, as I said earlier, is that we have two ways in which we can model our pump. The first one is by using the combination of reservoir with the pump, and also the other approach is by using the negative demand. So because in the previous tutorial we used the combination of reservoir and pump, so with this tutorial let us use the other approach, which is the negative demand approach. Okay, so now that we want to use the negative demand approach, what we need to do is to make sure that we have a negative demand at this junction here. Remember, this is the junction in which our pump is installed, 2.5 meters within the sump. Okay, so if I double click this, what I need to do is to insert or to make sure that I have a negative value within this base demand area here. So remember, what we wanted is to pump 3 liters per second from this point all the way to this point here. So if I minimize this, and what I need to do is to insert negative 3.5, negative 3 liters per second at this base demand area here. Remember, at this junction here. So if I close this, okay, so let me run my model and see if I have any issue. So let me run. You can see for now we have some issues. And if I read this closely, you can see we have some issues on our storage tank. So let me close this and go straight to my storage tank. So I need to set the elevation, which was 1162.7, if I'm not mistaken. And the initial level was, let me go back to WaterGEMS. The initial level was around 3 meters, and also the minimum level was around 0.15. So what I need to do is to insert here 3, and also the minimum level to maintain the way it is, and also the maximum level to maintain the way it is, and also the diameter to maintain 8 meters, which was the same as what we had on our WaterGEMS tutorial. So if you can check, you can see we have 8 meters around this area. And what I need to do next is to run again and see if we have any issue. So let me run this model. You can see for now we don't have any issue. So yes, we don't have any issue, but is that over? No, the answer is no. What we need to do next is to optimize our model and make sure that at least we have the pipe section or pipe sizes that we need for our network. So let me show you how we can achieve that. Okay, so from here, what I need to do, of course we did not have any issue, but what I need to do is to display, let's say, let me display the flow first, let me display the discharge first. Okay, let me display the amount of water that is pumped from this pump. Okay, I need to display flow. So if I run again, but we don't have any number, so let me right click this and select display. Then from here, let me select display. So this one, display link value, and also display the node value. And size, let me increase the size at least to 10. Then let me click OK. So for now we have 3 liters per second. Of course, this is the amount that we needed to pump from this area all the way to this area. Okay, and let me display again the velocity. But if you can tell, we have a very huge value of velocity, and this is not acceptable. So what we need to make sure that is to make sure that at least we have the velocity within acceptable range. Okay. So let me increase the diameter sizes to 90. Okay, let me 90, but to make things simple, what I can do and select all, then group edit, then let me select pipe. So with the diameter equal to 12, I need to replace it with the diameter equal to 90. Okay, let me click OK. Then click OK again. Then let me run again. You can see for now we have this amount of velocity, okay, which is 0.47. From here, what I need to do next, let me cross check the unit head loss. Of course, it's not that bad. It's 5.57, which is not that bad. Okay, and let me cross check the other thing is, of course, flow. This is our flow, which is 3 liters per second. Okay, at least for now, we have the system that we need. Okay, so now that we have the model that is well optimized, so the question is, which pump do we need for our network? Remember, the main objective is to make sure that at least we size the pump that we need for our network. Okay, so let me show you the properties of the pump that we need for this particular network. Okay, so from here, what I need to do, let me go straight to map. Let me select map. So under nodes, let me select pressure. Okay, so this is the values for pressure that we have on each junctions. Okay, but if I take you around this area here, remember this is 2.5 meters below the surface or 2.5 meters within the sump. And this is where our pump is installed, okay? This is where our pump is installed. But if you look closely, let me zoom it, you can see we have this value of pressure, which is 35.66. In other words, we need a pump that has a total pumping head of not less than 35.66 meters. And not just that, let me go back here to map and let me select links. So under links, let me select flow. Okay, so this is the flow, or this is the total discharge that we need to have from our pump. So in summary, we need to have a pump that has a total pumping head of 35.66 meters and also a discharge of not less than 3 liters per second. So that is how we can size water pump by using EPANET software, of course by using negative demand approach. And now that you are learning how to size water pumps by using EPANET software, I have a very good playlist which I highly encourage you to go and watch it. Of course it will be displayed on this end screen, so just click it and hopefully I'll see you on that playlist.